Hey everybody, how you doing? My name is Jeebs. I am an old media composer decomposing world music. So this is, you know, reacting and reflecting on music, different from my other channel, which is heavy metal and stuff, and having a great time over there. But this channel is about discovering new music artists from around the world, of which I have no idea, thank God, to YouTube. And also suggestions. I have a neighbor that I saw this morning, and we were talking, and I would say, hey, I'm going to get into some P-pop, and she told me about C-pop, but she also told me about Dimash Kudaibergen, forgive me, I don't know. Jamie, thank you very much for the suggestion. She said, I have to hear this performance. So this is Dimash doing S.O.S. apparently live. So I want to thank you all who are leaving your comments, those of you who are leaving suggestions. Remember, this journey for me is nothing without you leaving me suggestions. So I appreciate all that. And obviously, I get around to them as fast as I possibly can. So let's do this together. All right. Dimash Kudaibergen, and I'm sorry if I said it wrong. Please forgive me. Old guy. Singing the song live, apparently, S.O.S. All right.
Je vis, pourquoi je meurs, pourquoi je ris, pourquoi je pleure. Voici le SOS, quand t'as rien en détresse.
Was that four octaves? Oh my goodness. I was getting into this song, listening to the beautiful piano playing, you know, kind of in this very slow, semi-rubato kind of vibe to it. And then the strings come in and he's got such this beautiful tone. And then all of a sudden, he seemed to have dropped a complete octave and then lit it up and turned it around and came up to this higher octave. And I'm sure you saw me respond. I mean, I got a little bit of, we say here in Hawaii, chicken skin, but some people call it goosebumps. What a glassy tone to his voice. Very powerful, but yet very glassy. And I don't mean that in a fragile way. I mean, he obviously has a command on his abilities, but this is absolutely beautiful.
De jour qu'au fond de la vie avec les bons dessinés j'ai comme un zombie tu me t'as ma force je sens quelque chose qui m'attire
Okay, I hate to stop this here, but I think we can all agree already that I'm just absolutely beyond words with this gentleman's ability with his instrument. Now, you know, if you see me on my other channel, I'd never listen to lyrics. I always listen to the singer as an instrument. This is the instrument. And of course, we are the vessel, the human being, right? We project. That is what we do with our voices. Now, notwithstanding that this obviously is not in English, so that makes my life easier without trying to hear what he's saying word-wise so I can listen, you know, just to the performance. But I would be completely remiss if I did not talk a little bit about the arrangements behind this, okay? First of all, I'm hearing some really unique, fun engineering elements here. And what I mean by that is you know, that very long hall sound of a reverb that's on his voice. But there are a couple times that when he actually stops, he's at the end of his phrase, and if that's a hard stop at the end of the phrase, you can hear a left-right kind of pinging of a delay that's in tempo. Okay, so that's very purposeful. And then we hear the arrangements building. Obviously, the beginning was just the piano with a very light string arrangement. And then in the second come around, the arrangement starts to build, and then you hear a little bit of a, I'm going to say a loop. I don't know how it was created or anything, but excuse me, but there is kind of an EDM style loop behind it, very back in the mix. But you can hear it now. Now it's, you're beginning to get this essence that they've decided to commit to a tempo at this point. And then now as his arrangements and performance start to blow up, so do the string arrangements behind it. And they start to get richer and bolder. And don't forget, you know, arrangements, for me, what I listen for are counter-melodic structures in these arrangements. So while the singer is doing his beautiful melody and he's got these incredible intervals that he's singing, okay, those are the intervals. If you don't know, the intervals are the spaces between notes. Like no interval would be da 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 da. They would be these laps. Medium intervals might be da 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 da, but he's going da da da, you know, dog whistle. You know, so those are huge intervals, but the arrangements that are going around in the background are a very important part of supporting that. Sure, he could sing in a tunnel by himself and it would be amazing with a huge reverb, but as a composer, like I said, I would be just totally remiss if I didn't kind of glam a little bit on the power of the arrangement and the composition that's supporting until now. They're all in with the drums and the power, and the energy is, you know, being delivered in a very kind of, he's gone from this like soul-piercing beginning call to, you know, spiritual action, if you would, to now he's definitely grabbing a hold of the bull with this arrangement and stuff, and really, you know, coming across really super hard. I'm sorry, that was really long-winded, but hey, my jam. That was, without a doubt, a beautiful, bone-chilling end. Everything resolved. This heaviness of this song and where he was taking us with this arrangements, and I'll get back to the arrangements in just a second, by ending on this beautiful major chord. That's what happened there. For those of you who got all kinds of chicken skin or goosebumps or whatever they may call it in your country, the reason why I believe, I'm not an authority on feelings, but I know as music, as a composer, I can get that reaction from you if I'm going heavy and then I drop this at the very end. It could be one note or something, just a one note shift in the chord that could take it from a dark to all of a sudden this relieving, blooming, hopeful moment. And that's what happened in that last note. And it just went, thunk. I just got all chicken skin. It was just beautiful. Now, really quick before I end this, I want to go back to the arrangements. You notice when I started that second pass, I'm doing this. And that's because I'm listening. There's this ostinato. There's this really nice arrangement going on with the strings that happens there. And I really liked it. Then, of course, when the drums came in and everything, there was the power. There was the crunch. There's like a world music representation in this composition. There's a lot of everything happening here. A little bit of the, you know, Western metal guitar sound, and then you have, you know, this world classical, you know, style of arrangement, or at least hybrid orchestral kind of work. And then the one thing that I just like, I'm so kind of wrapped up in the arrangement, listen to the bass work. Listen to this track again. And when the drums are in and the bass is in there, listen to how the bass is actually, there's like multiple melodic arrangements in there. And even though the bass traditionally has the chore of hanging on to the bottom notes of, you know, that represent the root of the chord being played, but they also have the liberty of moving around in their own phrasing throughout it. That would be an arrangement. And listen to the arrangements of the bass too. So, I mean, it was just wonderful. Jamie, thank you so much for suggesting this to me. For those of you who are fans of this gentleman, please give me more music in the comments. Tell me, you know, what else I should listen to. There's no two ways about it. The future for this gentleman is unlimited. And I think that there's, without a doubt, a world audience for this. But it's already proven. Look at how many people are here. Maybe this was a talent show or something. I don't know if this was his show, but still yet. This was just an absolute joy to listen to. So I want to thank all of you who are hanging out on this channel and continuing on my journey through world music, world pop music. I'm going to be doing P-pop soon, Pinoy pop. And also, my friend who suggested this also said there was something called C-pop, and I guess that's Chinese too. So please, lay it on me, give me the comments, and I'll get through as many as possible. I hope you enjoyed hanging out here. Thank you so much for taking the time to hang out here. Time is valuable, and I appreciate it. I'm humbled that you stick through even this far. All right, guys, take care. Aloha.